quality until tonight. So I'm excited, I'm taking pictures too. I didn't know if anyone had any questions or if they have any thoughts they can direct my way, and we'd love to have your view of what we're doing and any ideas you have to make it better. We'll send out evaluations afterward, and it really helps us because this is the first season we're doing this, first year we're doing this, and we hope to do other programs possibly during school breaks, during after school programs. We just need your feedback so we know what you want. But if you have any questions, feel free to contact me either by phone, email, or here in person. The reason we do the art show at the end of the program is to make sure the kids get to see what they've accomplished and share what others have accomplished as well with their families and friends. I think that unless you display it, it can get hidden, it can get put in a closet, unfortunately, sometimes. But we really hope that it'll have at least this opportunity to display it, and hopefully at your own home, you have a place where you have a family relative that would love to display some of the art they've done, because I think it's worthy of exhibition anywhere. If you have thoughts about it, please let me know about what the kids have done, if you want to know how they did it. Allie can answer as well, and I'm happy to talk about it. All these processes take a while. The paper mache we started on Monday and didn't finish till today. While we're doing that project, we're doing paper castles, which again take 2 or 3 days to do. While they're doing that and they get on to the next project, we do the art canvas. That can take 2 or 3 days as well. So as you know, there's a lot of overlap, there's a lot of tables, there's a lot of activity going on. It's never ending. Just ask your kids about it. We're running around from one station to the next, but I think that it gives them in 4 days some understanding of what they can really do and how far they can go, and hopefully even further than this. But we try to do challenging projects for that reason. This is a place for them to do it. Might be harder at home, might be harder in the classroom at school, but this is an opportunity with 6 hours a day, 4 days a week, for us to be able to really, really make something happen. So I think there's a lot of special things happening on every table here, and I hope you enjoy. I hope you've seen a lot already and continue to. We have refreshments in the other room. We have a raffle here. We're raffling off these 2 wines. The kids actually did this yesterday. They got out there in the alleyway, whatever that driveway area, and they just rattled away. And they had fun. And I'm sure they had a method to it, Allie. But I know there's some kids that are eyeballing it right now that want it for their bedrooms. We're contributing all the proceeds from the raffle, which is $1 a ticket, to art scholarships, which we will keep in a separate fund for people who are in need and for people who have kids that are really, really into art, and that without that help, they might not be able to enjoy this experience. So just, you know, think about that as you walk around and enjoy the rest of the art that your children have.